Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video I'm going to show you how to blend. Now, of course, you know how blending objects work. So I have these circles and ellipses and they are stacked onto each other. And now I can select them all and go to Object, Blend, Make. And then I get a nice looking 3D ball. This consists of several objects and Illustrator calculates automatically the in-betweens. Now, maybe you have poked around in Illustrator's menus and maybe you have discovered another blend at another place, which is in here. Edit, Edit Colors, and there we have several blends. Now, what does that do? In order to show you that, I have basically the same object. So we have this blend and I have reduced the number of steps and then I have expanded that. So when doing that, what happens is that Illustrator generates the in-between. So I'm going to make a duplicate and then I'm going to edit the steps. Let's say we have 5 steps. And then we're going to Object, Blend, Expand, and then we get all these steps. So now you have this object, and now it's difficult to give this a different color because, well, you have to change them all. Now, in order to make that easy, what you can do is use the blend colors. So I'm going to ungroup this and then let's change the colors. Let's go in here and I want this in a light blue and I want the other one in a dark blue. So let's select it and change the color to a dark blue. And what I can now do is select them all and go to Edit, Edit Colors, and Blend Front to Back. And Illustrator generates the in-between colors. It doesn't touch the objects, it just changes the colors. So this is one way you can use that. Of course, you might know the typical use case for that when doing maps. So let's change this color to some light blue and let's have this white and then select all of those and go to Edit, Edit Colors, and again front to back, and we've got all the nice steps and we can delete the stroke as well, and then this is done. You can blend other geometrical orders as well. Now, I have all these circles and they are in no particular stacking order, but I want the top one to be, let's say, yellow, and I want the bottom one to be blue. So we can select them all and go to Edit, Edit Colors, and blend them vertically. And then Illustrator doesn't care for the stacking order, it just changes them in their vertical order. The same goes for Edit Colors, Blend Horizontally. So when they are aligned in horizontal order, you can change that as well. So that's how you can use those blend commands. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.